It's been a while. Ciao, Pertagatori. I had a different video in my pipeline, but I've seen something new on Steam and I want to test it out. It is a new game to draw fantasy maps, fantasy city maps. I totally enjoy testing this kind of softwares. And the reason behind this is that I am an illustrator, I am a cartographer, and I also like games, so... This software is the best mix for me, and I can't wait to play with it. So I'm now moving to my screen, which you can see, but just here. In the same time, I will record myself just to give you my very first impression. So this is my Steam page, don't mind about Baldur's Gate and other stuff. I can see the previews and I find it really interesting because I believe the software can help people building their own maps, which is super interesting. Yeah, I know this should be against my interests because I'm a cartographer, but the truth is that when I started to drawing maps, I made it for myself because I needed maps for my games. Kind of slowly, I began to draw for the other people. So my take on this is pretty simple. I just want people to be able to produce their own maps, to grow their skills, and create more fantasy games where we can play. Because I'm a player, I want marvelous games to jump in. Anyway, the previews are just lit. Love it. Let's go and test it. So welcome, hi, I'm glad you want to use Canvas of Night. Of course I do, I want to see what you made for us. This software is not perfect, don't worry about it. Feature complete and very likely containing bugs. I mean, you've just described my life, so don't show me again. No, show me again, I will forget. But let me see what we got. So we start with what I believe is the point of a pen, alright? Oh, it's a selection tool. Of course. Menu, object. Oh my, the gallery is insane. Ooh, they are randomized. I love it. Can you feel it incarnate? Ooh, the brushes. How can I move my camera? I really forgot. Oh, okay, USB. I love that the brushes are dropping a shadow. It gives a sense of depth. What do we have? Ruins? Oh, cultivations, some logs. What is it? They are trunks. Market stalls, and they are randomized. That's really interesting. So roofs, of course, more roofs. We got the well. Oh, animals too. So far, this is pretty interesting. I love that everything stays in scale, which is super important. Also, you can rotate each element. And I don't know if you can notice that the buildings do have glowing light and animations. I love it. And you can also add your own light source. Okay, okay, okay. Pretty, pretty cool so far. What else can we do? We have water source, fireplace, docks. Amazing. So let's go with simple houses. I didn't see any. Oh, okay, I do. We can keep rotation. That's really useful. Okay. This is extremely cool. The path to. How can I stop it? Double click? Oh, of course, I got all the info I needed at the bottom, but I didn't look at it. I can lift. Okay, I'm on my way to change my job. Well done. So how can I close it? How can I stop it? How can I stop it? Oh, all right, it was the right button. That's a lot to handle. Oh, can I? I wonder why I cannot select the walls. All right, I need to click on over each node. Yeah, that's a bit annoying. Plot to lake, ground with flowers. Anyone? I haven't seen it coming, but for all the fellows graphic design out there, do you remember all the hours you spent learning the curves? I have good news for you. Now all your efforts will start to make sense. Interesting. I love that you can curve the areas. I also love the edge is fading in a smooth way. Look at it. Amazing. Can I overlap elements? They don't overlap. Yeah, that's right. I'm wondering why. I wish they will insert a way to manage the layers and overlap stuff. Maybe it is already available and I didn't find it. Maybe it's not an issue for this version, but keep in mind to add something like this in the future. Oh no! I like that you have random animations. Oh, I can watch it. Do this animal appear because we have water? It would be interesting, AI. Room tool. I don't have a room tool yet. I can upload my own images. We can change the color of the environment. I'm wondering if I can switch day and night easily. Oh, let me zoom in. We got snow. Interesting. And we can also intensify it. You can customize your grid, you can change the color, and you can also change from square to hexagon. I really need a way to remove the entire thing. Let's start with water. So don't mind about using this kind of sharp segment, because you can always morph the angles and make them more roundish. No, I just want to move one. How can I move only one? Oh wait, no, no. And now we have a water source. What can we do? Oh, let's go to objects, docks. I made the wrong scale. Not really what I had in mind. So map size. If I move the handle just behind the trash can icon, click the icon, that's not good. I'm just to report to you this bug. Now the dots are more as I intended them to be. I'm on the path tool to draw an artwork. Is it possible to select it? No. Press G to make it lower. Oh, you can make it disappear in the water. AI is insane. Really cool. Let's keep it this way, I like it. So, let's draw a new part of this path. Wait, can I change the size? Oh, can I change my selection? Press tab. Can I rotate them, please? Okay, love it. Do we have boards? Oh, that's huge. I want to see more options of... Can we have a smaller one? Scale up, scale down. So I assume I can change the scale of this one too. Yeah, that's not the way I wanted. That's something nice. Interesting. So let's build some houses. We all need a tower. Of course, we need a tower. Well. I want it to be outside the walls, so it would be just here, in front of the ocean. Now, maybe this one? More houses, like this. Can I also combine them? Okay, nice call. When you click and draw your line, remember to click another point to place your segment, and only then you can click with the right button. Oh, so if I press shift, it will start a new path. But let's go with some houses first. Why is the color different? I'm not really finding myself with the keys, maybe. I think that's just on me. I'm pretty bad with keyboards. I also want to put a marketplace, but before I want to change the background. Looks like I can place the marketplace in the same way. Like this. Oh, nice. Oh, let's move the marketplace here. Of course, it's not visible. Damn it. That's too bad, too bad, too bad, too bad. Please don't snap. Don't snap. What is this? So I can detach it and move every part by itself. That's really smart. Congratulations. Citizens? Do we need citizens? Forest. Ah, yes. I want a lot of trees going on around. And this. Do I see it right? Are trees moving? When I select the trees, can I change them? I can lower them. this is interesting. If you want to create a map of a rural area, you want to show the growth of the trees and the vegetation. That's really interesting. Love it. Yes, yes. So those are flowers. Let's go with a well. One already here and the other one just here. Ah, this more. Go away, you tiny well. Yes, we got beams, fireplaces. They are lightful, of course. You go, bird, set free. How am I supposed to have doors and gates? I don't see any. Two stones. Let's go random. Let's be random. If you place them in water, they change the environment. This is super nice. Oh, look, who's dead? No. Okay. So let me think, how would this bend in a natural way? People are not making the curve, people are walking straight. Assuming you can walk just under this roof, the curve will go around the objects. Now, let's play shift under this. What? Show. And maybe the second one, which is not blending the best way, we can resize it. Not this much. Fine. Let's keep it. Let's say this could be a place to keep your animals. Why this is to keep you safe. Why dirt road? What could it be? Something like this. That's weird. I would love to just lower one small point. I think I can't. I don't understand. What's happening? Let's place trees on me. Sometimes shadows are a bit out of range. I don't know what is happening. I wanted to make more bushes, but they just appear randomly. Where are you, bush? Never mind. Plant rows. Fine. What if I did something like this? I wish I could change the density of the plants, like having more control. But wait, if I can detach stuff in it? No, I don't. Don't mind. Less points are better. Oh, finally. Let me see. Can I change the colors? Water objects, black color. So far, I have no idea where the gates are. I don't know. Okay, let me share some impressions. But first of all, let's give a look to this map. This software is really interesting. You have enough freedom to make basic shapes. You can randomize objects. You can randomize rotation and size. You can play with the height. So when you place something nearby the water or in the water, you can raise them all above. The AI in this sense is really functional. I love that some items can merge. And if it is a demo, as a cartographer, I shall think about something for my future. So I told you what I think are the best options, but there are something I don't like. The first thing is that you don't have much freedom about positioning between layers. Second thing is gates. Seriously, I totally need an icon to represent gates and doors. It would be useful for players to have some sort of indicator, so think about it. The third point is I hope in the future version of this software they will allow you to change colors of the items in a separate way or by groups, because I didn't like that you can't. There are really minor bugs. I would suggest to put the hotkeys in a place you can see inside. Maybe you can have a tutorial kind of suggestion box appealing somewhere, and it's a good tool. You know, we are in that moment of the present, which is the future for some of us. And of course, I'm expecting to see many different programs which will allow us to replace some drawing techniques. Even if I love to get to know different programs to make faster maps, I will always suggest you to explore, to take a pen and try drawing yourself everything you need. Programs are cool, they will help you with setting science, but there is a limitation that the machine can have, and that limitation is only between you and your imagination. Don't try to say that
my limitations that I can draw.
Don't you dare. I am a professional illustrator and I'm a professional cartographer, and still I perceive myself as a beginner, because in this journey you never stop learning, and this is why I'm saying don't not underestimate you. Just draw. Draw and enjoy the process. Let me introduce myself. Hi, I'm Ren, I'm a professional cartographer and illustrator. And if you enjoy contents about drawing, RPG games and maps, welcome to my channel. Oh my god, the summer is endless and I'm one step away from cutting all my hair.